Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Jayashree Jawaji. Today we'll be continued reading from the book Sachin Tendulkar, Playing It My Way, My Autobiography with Boria Majumdar, Part 48. Second Test, Nottingham, 27-31 July 2007, England 198, A.N. Cook 43, Zeb Khan 4-59, A. Kumble 3-32 and 355, M.P. Wagon 124, P.D. Collingwood 63, A.J. Strauss 55, Zeb Khan 5-75, A. Kumble 3-104, India 481, S.R. Tendulkar 91, S.C. Ganguly 79, K.D. Karthik 77, W. Jaffer 62, V.V.S. Lakshman 54, M.S. Panesar 4-101, C.T. Tremlett 3-80 and 73-3, K.D. Karthik 22, W. Jaffer 22, S.R. Tendulkar 1, C.T. Tremlett 3-12. India won by 7 wickets. Third Test, the Oval, 9-13 August 2007, India 664, A. Kumble 110, M.S. Dhoni 92, K.D. Karthik 91, S.R. Tendulkar 82, R. Dravid 55, V.V.S. Lakshman 51, J.M. Anderson 4-182 and 180-6, Deck S.E. Ganguly 57, S.R. Tendulkar 1, P.D. Collingwood 2-24, J.M. Anderson 2-34, C.T. Tremlett 2-58, England 345, I.R. Bell 63, P.D. Collingwood 62, A.N. Cook 61, Z. Khan 3-32. A. Kumble 3-94, S.R. Tendulkar 1-26 and 369-6. K.P. Peterson 101, I.R. Bell 67, S. Srisant 3-53, match drawn. India won the series 1-0. India in Australia 2007-8. The Border Gavaskar Trophy First Test, Melbourne 26-29, December 2007. Australia 343, M.L. Hayden 124. P.A. Jack 66, A. Kumble 5-84, Z. Khan 4-94 and 351-7, M.J. Clark 73, P.A. Jack 51, H. Singh 3-101, India 196, S.R. Tendulkar 62, S.A. Ganguly 43, S.R. Clark 4-28, B. Lee 4-46 and 161, V.V.S. Lakshman 42, S.A. Ganguly 40, S.R. Tendulkar 15, M.G. Johnson 3-21, Bailey 3-43, G.B. Hawk 2-51, Australia 1 by 337 runs. Second Test, Sydney 2-6, January 2008, Australia 463, A. Simmons 162, G.B. Hawk 79, Bailey 59, R.T. Ponting 55, A. Kumble 4-106, R.P. Singh 4-124 and 401, 7 Deck, M.A.K. Hase 145, M.L. Hayden 123, A. Simon 61, A. Kumble 4-148, India 532, S.R. Tendulkar 154, V.V.S. Lakshman 109, S.E. Ganguly 67, H. Singh 63, R. Dravid 53, B. Lee 5-119 and 210, S.E. Ganguly 51, A. Kumble 45, S.R. Tendulkar 12, M.J. Clark 3-5, A. Simons 3-51, Australia 1 by 122 runs. Third Test, Perth, 16-19 January 2008, India 330, R. Dravid 93, S.R. Tendulkar 71, M.G. Johnson 4-86, Billy 3-71 and 294, V.V.S. Lakshman 79, I.K. Pathan 46, S.R. Tendulkar 13, S.R. Clark 4-61, Billy 3-54, Australia 212, A. Simon 66, S.E. Gilchrist 55, R.P. Singh 4-68, I. Sharma 2-34, A. Kumble 2-42 and 340, M.J. Clark 81, M.G. Johnson 50, M.A.K. Hase 46, I.K. Pathan 3-54, V. Sehwag 2-24, India 1 by 72 runs. Fourth Test, Adelaide 24-28 January 2008, India 526, S.R. Tendulkar 153, A. Kumble 87, V. Sehwag 63, H. Singh 63, V.V.S. Lakshman 51, M.G. Johnson 4-126, B. Lee 3-101 and 269-7 Deck, V. Sehwag 151, S.R. Tendulkar 13, M.G. Johnson 2-33, B. Lee 2-74, Australia 563, R.T. Ponting 140, M.J. Clark 118, M.L. Hayden 103, P.A. Jack 60, I.K. Pathan 3-112, I. Sharma 3-115, V. Sehwag 2-51, match drawn. Australia won the series 2-1. 9. Bouncing back. The 2008 one-day tri-series in Australia with Sri Lanka as the third team was a hard-fought competition. A lot of the tension from the controversial test series that preceded it was carried into the limited overs arena, and the Indian team under new captain MS Dhoni were determined to return to India with the Commonwealth Bank Trophy. The pitch at the MCG on 10th February was one of the fastest I've played on. We fielded first and Dhoni was standing way back and still had to catch most balls at chest height. I was standing at slip, which was at the edge of the 30-yard circle, an indication of the pace and bounce of the pitch. I remember mentioning to Dhoni after an outside edge of Matthew Hayden's bat flew past me that the pitch was going to favour the fast bowlers throughout the match and no chase was going to be easy. Our bowlers used the conditions well and dismissed Australia for only 159. Ishan bowled beautifully again to pick up 4-38 and Srishant also did well. Taking 3-31 at the break, our dressing room was boycotted. Though we knew that their fast bowlers would enjoy the conditions just as much. It was enough to fire me up. As he walked past, I just muttered to myself that come what may, I was going to take him on. It turned out to be one of our most memorable contests. My chance came in the fifth over. Sehwag had just been dismissed at the other end. LBW to left arm seamer Nathan Bracken for 11 and Lee was teaming in. His second ball was slightly wide, but I still decided to go for a drive through cover. I connected moderately well and the ball raced to the face. Lee just gave me another smile and walked back to his mark. I thought I knew what he would try next. He ran in fast and, as anticipated, bowled a fuller length ball. I came down hard at it and hit it straight back at him. It must have been one of the most powerful shots I have hit in my life. By now, Lee was even more pumped up and the next ball was at 151 kph delivery, which I defended off the back foot. I was determined to keep attacking and I got another opportunity off the fifth ball of the over. It was full and fast and again, I hit it back past Lee for 4. While the first straight drive had gone to the left of the bowler, this one went to his right. Those two drives gave me a lot of confidence and I went on to make 44 when I got out in the 26th over. We needed 64 runs and Rohit Sharma and Dhoni played well to finish off the job. Immediately after the match, I started to feel some soreness in my adductors, the muscles in the groin, and informed John Gloucester about the problem. Sri Lanka scored 179 with Ishan Sharma and Praveen Kumar both taking 4 wickets, and when our innings started, I managed to connect well from the off and went on to make 63 and we knocked off the runs in 33 overs. It felt good to spend time out in the middle again after several low scores, and I headed to Sydney for the first final relieved at having scored some runs. While I was looking forward to the finals, I was conscious that the pain in my adductors was getting worse after every practice session. I have problems with running, twisting and even bending down to pick up a ball. It reached a stage where in fielding practice I had to just stand at the stumps while my teammates threw the ball in. With the final just a day away, painkillers were the only remedy. CB Series first final Sydney 2nd March 2008. Before the finals, the atmosphere got a little heated again when Ricky Ponting declared that Australia would have to play only the first two of the three finals, as that was all it would take to send India packing. His comments only added to our determination. Australia batted first at the SCG after winning the toss. It is usually a sensible ploy to bat first in a big final, because even a mediocre score can be made to look good in a must-win situation. Australia made 239 on the day, with Matthew Hayden contributing 82, and we didn't think it was a bad total in good bowling conditions. Robin Uthappa was opening the batting with me, and our first task was to see off the new ball. We knew that if the team batted our full 50 overs, we should win the match, and I advised Robin to be patient and not to be aggressive early in the innings. Being a naturally attacking batsman, Robin was itching to play his shots, and at one point I had to get a little angry with him, telling him not to go anything rash. We managed not to lose a wicket until the 11th over, when Robin played his first big pull shot to deep square leg, where Mike Jose caught the ball low down. Robin might have scored only 17, but he had helped see off the new ball, and we had put together a 50-run first wicket partnership. I sensed that the match would be ours if we kept our new nerve. Unfortunately for us, we lost Gautam Gambhir and Yuvraj within a few overs and needed another partnership to rebuild the innings. Rohit Sharma had come out to bat, and I asked him to play straight and not try any fancy shots early on. He batted brilliantly, and soon we were in a position to grind down the opposition. Rohit finally got out to all-rounder James Hopes for 66 just after I had reached my century. Dhoni came out next, and we knocked off the 30 runs needed to finish the match quite easily in the end. The one only scare was a beamer from Brett Lee that hit me on the side of my helmet grill and the top of my left shoulder. The ball had slipped out of his hand and could very easily have injured me. I felt a little dizzy and jokingly suggested to Lee that he would have answer to my son Arjun when he next went to Mumbai. Lee knew Arjun well and had spent some time with my family when he had filmed their Boost commercial together. He apologized immediately and the matter was put to rest there and then. It was an accident, of course, but the shoulder felt sore and the area between shoulder and elbow turned back. It was a very satisfying feeling to bat through the innings. It was a big match, but we decided not to celebrate too much because the second final in Brisbane was only a day away and we knew it was going to be tough because of the high humidity. I could not sleep a wink that night and ached all over. The pain in my groin had increased and I was starting to get scared. The next morning I could barely walk and it was an ordeal boarding the early morning flight. In Brisbane, I was given a long massage as soon as we reached the hotel. Seeing my condition, Dhoni suggested that maybe I should miss the second final and play in the third if needed. I said to him that, "Sher jab gira hua hota hai, use tabhi mar do." When a tiger is down and out, just finish it off. Don't give it a second chance. He agreed with me that it would be better to close out the competition in Brisbane if we could. CB Series Second Final Brisbane 4 March 2008. When we arrived at the Gabba, we found that there was a lot of moisture in the pitch. It was bound to be difficult for batting early on and the obvious plan was to field first if we won the toss. But I urged Dhoni not to do so. I reckoned that the Australians might well want to bat first. Preferring to bat without the pressure of chasing a target, I thought it would be better if we set a target, even if it meant struggling through the initial period of dampness on the wicket. Dhoni agreed and we batted first. Again, I told Robin Uthappa in no uncertain terms not to risk a single expansive shot till we had played out the first 10 overs. In those conditions, not losing wickets was far more important than trying to score runs. Robin successfully held back and we survived the first 20 overs intact, giving us a solid foundation to launch on assault. We then scored at almost 6 runs an over and ended up with 258, a reasonable score to defend in the circumstances. I was pleased to score 91, but by the end of the innings, I also knew that my body was in bad shape and if we weren't able to win in Brisbane, I would be in no condition to play the third final. In fact, I was forced to leave the field in fourth over of the Australia innings when Dhoni dived to catch Hayden off Srishant and the ball ricocheted and hit me exactly where I had been hit by the Lee Beamer. Meanwhile, our opening bowler Praveen Kumar produced a great press spell and picked up three crucial Australian wickets. Hayden and Simons then put together a big partnership and the stage was set for Baji to have the final word on Australian soil. First, he ran Hayden out, following a misunderstanding with Simons, and then just two balls later, Simons missed a ball that turned a long way and was tabbed LBW unsurprisingly. Baji enjoyed his wicket more than any other. The match wasn't over yet, however, with James Hopes playing some aggressive strokes in the end. Hopes was out last for 63, but by picking up wickets regularly at the other end, we had ensured that he was constantly under pressure. Nevertheless, the match was closer than expected and when the final wicket fell, Australia were only 10 runs away from winning the game. It was a great feeling to win and seeing the tricolour being waved all over the Gabba was a terrific sight. We had beaten Australia in Australia and were also delighted to have proved Ricky Ponting right. He did not have to play a third final just as he had predicted. Okay all, let's end up for today. We shall continue to start reading the chapters of the book with the next video. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe.